Hey everyone, my name is Kajal and welcome to another ROS2 tutorial video. In today's video, we will learn about ROS2 services. In the previous video, we learned about ROS2 nodes and topics. I'll link the previous tutorial in the card on the top right corner and in the description below. For today's video, we'll go over what are ROS2 services and we'll also go through an example of using ROS2 services with the TurtleSim package. I've included all of the timings and useful resources in the description below. So without further ado, let's get into it. Starting with what is a ROS2 service. A ROS2 service is a special type of communication between two nodes to send a request to perform a specific task and receive the answer as a response. In other words, it's a call and response model. You call on a service and another node receives this request and responds with a message. For example, you could have a service request to convert Euler angles to quaternions. The node requesting this service will send Euler angles as a message, and once the task is performed, it will receive a response in quaternions. On one end, you have a server as part of a ROS2 node that provides the service, and on the other hand, you have a client as part of another ROS2 node that requests and receives this service. Unlike ROS2 topics, where publishers continuously publish a message, ROS2 services are on demand. This is why when you want to publish a message continuously, such as sensor readings, you use topics. On the other hand, you might want to use services for one-off or occasional communication. Similar to ROS2 topics, where multiple subscribers can subscribe to a message, in ROS2 services, multiple nodes can request the same service. However, only one ROS2 node can provide a specific services, unlike topics, where multiple nodes can publish to the same topic. Let's get started with an example. We'll use the TurtleSim package to learn about ROS2 services. To start the simulator, open a terminal and type the following command. ROS2 run TurtleSim TurtleSim_node. This should open a window with a turtle in it. Now, let's get a list of ROS2 services. Switch to an Opal terminal window or start another terminal window using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+Shift+T and type the following command. ROS2 services list. This shows a list of ROS2 services available from all the nodes that are running right now. You'll see a few services with the name parameter in it, and it's the same option for both the nodes, such as get parameter type. All of this is part of another feature of ROS2 called parameter and will be covered in another tutorial. For now, let's focus on services. Instead of remembering different commands associated with services, you can use help. Type the following command. ROS2 services --help. You can see all the options available for ROS2 services. Let's try the call service, which calls a ROS2 service. Once again, we will use help to understand how to use the ROS2 call command. Type the following in your terminal. ROS2 service call --help. As you can see in the terminal, you need the name of the service, type of the message, and the values in YAML format. We can scroll up and get the name of a ROS2 service. I'm using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+Shift+C to copy the name spawn. This service lets us spawn another turtle in our simulation. Next, let's find out the type of message for this service. For this, type the following in your terminal. ROS2 service type and the name of service. As you can see on the screen, we now have the message type as well. To get more information about the specifics of this message type, we will use the interface command. Type the following. ROS2 interface show service type. Once again, I'm using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+Shift+C to copy and Ctrl+Shift+V to paste. This shows us the type of message to send for calling a service and the type of message we will receive from the service. Both of these are separated by the dashed line. In this case, we will send the coordinates x, y, and theta where the new turtle will be created, along with an optional name for our turtle. The service will create another turtle and also return the name of that turtle. With that, let's call the service. Type the following command: ROS2 service call name of the service, type of the message, and the message itself in YAML format. As seen on the terminal, we have sent a request and we also got a response with turtle 2. And if you look at our simulation window, there's now a second turtle. Now if you type the following command, ROS2 topic list, you can see a second set of topics for the second turtle similar to the first one. As explained in the last tutorial, you can use pub to publish a message and move this turtle. Try the following command: ROS2 topic pub topic name message type and the message. As you can see on the screen, this moves our second turtle forward. I will add the link to the next tutorial once it is published. You can also check out other tutorial videos on my channel. Before you go, if you enjoyed this tutorial, make sure to give this video a like. If you have any question, use the comment section below. And if you want to reach out, take a look at the description. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.